release that lateral pterygoid muscle, that nasty little muscle that can cause jaw pain, headaches, pain behind the eye, ear pain, and it can limit your range of motion. And if it's really tight, it can even cause popping, clicking, or jaw locking. So this muscle is sort of at the crux of a lot of TMJ issues. And for almost every single one of my patients, we release this muscle at their therapy appointments. People usually come to see me every 2 to 3 weeks while they're in treatment. Some people see me weekly because they're in that much pain or their jaw is locked closed. So to release this muscle, you want to take your pinky. So you're going to take the pinky on the opposite side that you're going to release. Then you're going to sort of turn it so that the nail is facing towards your face. And then you're going to open pretty wide and put your finger all the way back between your cheek and between your teeth. So it doesn't go onto the roof of your mouth. It goes between the cheek and the teeth, pretty much as far back and as far up as you can go. Then once you're there, you're going to close your mouth halfway. And you're gonna find that you can go further back and further up. Once you're back there, you're gonna apply pressure for about 10 to 15 seconds, and then you're gonna sort of change the angle, press up again, and apply that same pressure. This does not feel good for many people who have TMJ issues. This hurts. It can actually bring tears to your eyes. But most people, the vast majority, will say that it hurts so good, and it brings relief. So it brings relief from jaw pain and headaches, and it also can increase the range of motion. There's a very small number of people where this actually triggers more pain. So be careful, kind of test it out. Don't go in guns blazing with a lot of pressure the first few times you do this. Kind of test it out and see if it helps. So I'm gonna go ahead and show it to you guys. I'm gonna take my pinky. Close halfway. Go further back and up and Now change the angle. So that's sort of the shortened version of it. If you have long nails, do not do this. You will hurt yourself. So you have to have a short pinky nail at least to do this. You can see I keep mine very short. So go ahead and do that. You can do it like once, maybe twice a day. Don't overdo it, and do it on both sides. Even if you have only one side that's hurting a lot, if you do it on the opposite side, I can pretty much guarantee that that side is sore too. So go ahead and give this a try. Make sure you save this video so you can do this again and again. Follow, and I will see you all soon.